Hey there, folks. Welcome back to Let's Play WWE 2K15 2K Showcase Way of the Warrior. I'm the mysterious JG, and now you must deal with the creation of all the unpleasantries in the universe. Lay down on the lawn and let the lawnmowers run over you. I'm quoting a couple of Ultimate Warrior promos. I don't know. Part of me wants to go back and restart this whole LP and just try to get in character as the warrior, but I can't maintain his level of intensity. But I would strongly recommend, if you're watching this, that you take the time out to just look at one or two warrior promos online. There's a video I was just watching that kind of takes together little highlights from multiple warrior promos. Certainly the fact that it's chopped up doesn't make it any more or less comprehensible than an old-school warrior promo would be. It does create the false impression that he maintains the top level of energy at all times, because sometimes he does fluctuate. Went back and watched. I didn't watch the Rocket Fuel promo. I watched the Crashing the Plane of Hulkamania promo, and it made less sense than I remember, because he's asking Hulk Hogan to kick down the door to the cockpit and dispose of the pilots and crash the Hulk Hogan plane into a nosedive, and is wondering if Hulk Hogan will have the same fear as the, quote, normals, or if he will reassure the normals. I don't know. At any rate, let's see what our special moves are. We got Ultimate Splash, Gorilla Press is a signature? Oh, interesting. I would have thought that would have been a finisher in this game. But yeah, normally he finished people off with a splash after hitting the Gorilla Press. That was always the combo. Just the splash on its own, I don't think was ever supposed to be the deal. But, you know, it is what it is. We got Hulk Hogan, who I don't think we get to play as Axe Bomber. Because there's a special Hulkamania edition you could buy. Like, it costs, like, twice as much. I mean, you know, for something I've really been anticipating for a long time, like, you know, the new Metal Gear Solid game that's coming out later this year, I would think about the collector's edition, not for this. And, not for more Hulk Hogan, but... Eh, whatever. Let's get back to the game.
Versus champion. Title. Versus
so I just
title. This is what it's all about.
Yeah, this is what
reversing
it's
the Irish whip.
Reverse the Irish whip. Going for the stumps. I am the lawnmower. Running you over on the lawn. Whoa, Hogan.
It's the ultimate challenge. And both men appear to be in tremendous physical condition. They are definitely ready for this one.
Yeah, some chain wrestling from Baltimore and Hulk Hogan here.
Here we go with Hulk Hogan.
That's what these two were all about, arm ringers. Oh man, Hulk Hogan's really showing me up in the chain wrestling. And in fairness, Hulk Hogan was better at chain wrestling than Warrior was, and he was not known as being the greatest chain wrestler ever.
Oh, that's devastating. Oh, wait, nice reversal. And he's toast.
I'm trying to do the clothesline. I guess that's the light tap instead of the... Oh shit. Because that's how I remember Ultimate Warrior's matches generally going.
Warrior fans nervous. Only once in the 5-year history of WrestleMania has the Intercontinental Champion won a match at this illustrious event.
And that victory came back at WrestleMania 2 when Randy Savage turned back George the Animal Steel.
And here's some more bad news for Warrior fans. Warrior is on that list of Intercontinental Champions that have lost at WrestleMania. It was just last year that he fell to Rick Rude, losing his title in the process.
Oh, man, we don't get to see the Rick Rude match?
Championship from Rude in August.
We probably get to see the match where he beats Rick Rude.
Champion versus
Rick
champion.
Rude, by the way, awesome.
Title title.
Yeah, there you go. Now it's more like an Ultimate Logan. Warrior match.
Did you hear how his leg connected? And I think he's
but I've used up all my stamina.
Oh, a devastating
I think going for lots of clotheslines and tiring myself out early is sure. My best way of representing what an Ultimate Warrior match is truly like.
He was able to reverse that.
So disrespectful.
New champions have been crowned in each of the last two WrestleManias. Ultimate Warrior looking to make it 3 in a row here against Hulk Hogan.
And of course, it was the Hulkster defeating Randy Macho Man Savage in the main event of last year's WrestleMania to capture the WWE Championship.
Damn. And tomorrow will mark the 1-year anniversary of Hogan's title reign.
It's really not fair that Ultimate Warrior doesn't have infinite stamina.
Yeah, and that's easier said than done, Cole. You know, with the way Warrior has looked in recent weeks, I wouldn't be surprised.
I mean, if we're trying to recapture the spirit of what his matches were like, he should be running around clotheslining nonstop.
Hogan took his time getting down to the ring. He kept his cool and conserved his energy. Unlike Ultimate Warrior, who bolted to the ring. He may have exhausted himself before this one even started.
The nerve hold, which somehow affects the body.
clearly on the offensive.
Yeah, it's certainly something to keep an eye on as this match progresses. If Warrior can't get out of the box, it may be because of his pre-match sprint to the ring. Well, obviously, the edge of experience...
Referee taken out by Warrior.
Yes, but then again...
Which has been happening in every match so far. It's kind of odd.
Six of one, half dozen of the other. That's why there are 68,000 screaming fans here in Toronto for WrestleMania. It's so evenly matched.
Man, it's going for a leg hold, this Ultimate Warrior. I don't know what that was about.
This match has been a long time in the making, King, dating all the way back to their encounter.
Go back to that nerf hold.
In January.
And, of course, that night it was Hulk Hogan eliminating Ultimate Warrior from the Rumble.
To be fair, though, Warrior's elimination may have been collateral damage. Hogan's sights were seemingly set on the Barbarian and Rick Rude.
Yeah, it was a weird thing back in the day. A babyface couldn't eliminate another babyface from the Royal Rumble without turning heel in the process. It's like they're all trying to win. Yeah. Lawless got it.
Swinging neck breaker.
Oh. Okay, suddenly I can't hit anything. Ultimate Warrior with his trademark belly-to-belly suplex.
Oh, there it
is. Yeah, that wasn't wise. Trying to get a little health or stamina back here, but...
It's been deafening in here since the onset of this match. They've been cheering for the Hulkster. They've been cheering for the Warrior. What a confrontation.
Oh, the ultimate challenge has
See, I don't know how to
that.
Do his comeback.
No doubt in the annals of sports entertainment, WrestleMania 6 will go down as being the site of perhaps the biggest
man
of all time.
That's bullshit. I got my counter move countered. Or my comeback move countered.
Overpowered like this.
But Hogan is a true champion. And if there's anything we've learned from Hogan matches, of the past, there is
it's
no
that there's no
the
kicking out of the big boot.
King. The unfortunate part is that only one man will walk out. Crazy move.
Axe bomber.
For the first time ever, this could do it.
For the first time ever, this could do it. That's a little ridiculous. I'm not looking to win here at this rate. That was another move Hulk Hogan pretty much never did. This is not going well.
He thinks he has it.
And I just... Okay. Grapple Hulk Hogan? I never even did that? Oh, you know what? I actually lost track of the fact that I was supposed to be doing specific things. I was just trying to win.
Here we go, King. Champion versus champion. Title versus title. This is what it's all about.
Yeah, this is what it's
about.
An amazing 68,000 fans here to WrestleMania. Ultimate Warrior taking on Hulk Hogan.
All right.
The turnbuckle pads coming off.
I didn't mean to do that. Ultimate Warrior using some shady tactics here. By mistake.
For the first time ever, WrestleMania comes to you from north of the border here in Toronto, a city rich in sports entertainment history.
Oh, you're right. A lot of great names have come from Toronto over the years, and I'm sure many more will. Heck, there may even be a future WWE superstar in the crowd right now.
Oh, yeah, it's a reference to Edge. Very cute. And Christian. No, Christian wasn't actually in there. The president was. All right, you know what? You prevented me from taking the,
Oh, man, is he fired
You prevented
up.
Me from taking the turnbuckle pad off, but I'm still going to try to use dirty tactic now for some reason. Ultimate Warrior turning heel on Hogan.
Oh, big collision with that restraining wall. Steel steps. Big
this is not how this match went.
And did you hear the impact on that kick?
You know, here's a stat that should make Ultimate Warrior fans nervous. Only once in the 5-year history.
Here's something that should make Ultimate Warrior fans nervous. His comic book will become famous only for the bizarre panel on which he appears to be ready to rape Santa Claus. Yes, that's a real thing.
And Alan is show off time.
his time gloating here.
Seemingly lost track of which button means grapple.
Snake eye. Forehead and nose right down in that turnbuckle.
Oh, nice. After that, you're not forehead and nose, stars, baby. Apes and cranes. Oops.
And he does it one more time.
Ow.
And Warrior counters. Oh, my. Another thunderous move.
Folk.
Obviously, the edge of experience in this
I hate you almost as much as I hate Santa.
Six of one, half dozen of the other. That's why there are 68. Oh, this match is huge.
There we go. Button press sequence here.
Look at the Warrior.
Chest slamming sequence.
He's showing his strength against Hogan.
Yeah, this is a match we've been waiting for a long time.
And now Hogan shows his strength against the Warrior. Let's try that again. Here we go.
Let's start crisscrossing for no good reason.
Hogan drops down. Hogan with a huge slam on the Ultimate Warrior.
Yeah, but Warrior got right back.
It's a no-sell contest.
Can't believe it, Kang. Oh, my gosh. Hogan is stunned. Now what? Both these superstars.
Now do you suppose Warrior will slam Hogan and Hogan will no-sell?
Warrior down. Hogan.
Oh no, Hogan actually sold it,
Hogan,
that's right.
Popping right up. Nice reversal there.
More snake eyes. Oh yeah. Ultimate snake eyes. Oh no, he blocked
Hogan
the clothesline.
Warrior cut off that attack fast.
That's because everything Warrior does is fast, Cole. You know that. What a shot!
This including his self-destructing.
This is not where the Hulkster wants to be right now.
No, it's not. You're not going to win too many matches
DVD.
On your back.
The Hulkster appears to be in trouble here. Rarely do you ever see Hogan overpowered like this.
But Hogan is a true champion. And if there's anything we've learned from Hogan matches of the past, there is no quit in the Hulkster.
Both men are truly segueing into a pre-rendered sequence.
And now, oh man,
the referee devastating Warrior there.
Of that collision, but he still sees that Hulk Hogan is down. Now what's Warrior going to do, Michael?
Oh, he's getting ready for the red arrow.
What? Look out, Hulk. Incoming. Ooh. Double axe handle.
And in fairness, this match had the fans, like, out of their minds with excitement, I got to say.
He's going up again. It's unbelievable.
Warrior up to the top rope now.
Takes a while to build somebody up to the degree Warrior had been built up to by this point. Even if all you got to see was a match with Honky Tonk and a match with Andre.
Warrior is ready to go here.
Button press sequence? No, just cinematics. The moving out of the way counter. Hogan getting a little heelish here. Hogan's like, I totally should have won the title by him missing a shoulder block. Throw that in there so Hogan gets to look like he should have won, maybe.
Yeah, but Hogan can't capitalize because the official is knocked down by the Warrior.
Oh, wait, Warrior's up.
And Hogan doesn't have a clue. Ultimate Warrior.
Hogan never has a clue. That's why he did Thunder in Paradise.
Hogan dropped hard. The back of his head hitting the canvas.
And now it's Warrior.
Now Warrior should be winning based on that one
Warrior
suplex. There's some fan with like a Hanna-Barbera rendition of Honky Tonk Man on the street. This is sufficiently different from the WWE 2K14 portrayal of the same match. And that match had a lot more of you actually controlling what was going on.
Oh my gosh. I'd say 2 3/4. That was so close.
Warrior can't believe it.
Warrior gonna splash the referee as punishment.
These two superstars are so evenly matched. What's gonna happen here?
Well, what's my new objective? Defeat Hulk Hogan by pinfall or submission. That'll do it.
And a kick out by Hogan. And
Hogan's it's another cinematic. He's hulking up.
This is vintage Hulk Hogan. To borrow one of your phrases, Colvin, look at Warrior.
Cole had not even used that phrase. When did Cole ever say vintage Hulk Hogan?
No, he's getting stronger. Oh.
Who's doing this to you, Hulk Hogan?
Here he goes, Cole.
Indicate the target of your wrath, Hulk Hogan.
Hogan on fire. Warrior can't stop him. Uh-oh.
You. Oh man, you called it before it happened, Lalo. You totally took me out of it there. Okay, now I gotta have a button smash sequence here.
Big boot! Oh, the leg drop by Hogan misses! And Warrior with a big splash! This could be it! Hooks on the leg! Shoulders down! Warrior wins! Who got him? Warrior beats Hogan!
What? So, okay.
Look at this, Michael!
Why didn't it do the little unlocks? I guess, because I had one button I had to press successfully. Now Hulk Hogan's gonna waffle him with the belt. Precursor to Hollywood Hogan. This is the guy right here who wanted me to kill pilots who crash an airplane, brother.
And King, the question has to be asked. Was the torch passed tonight?
Oh, that didn't seem fair. There was somebody held up an Ultimate Warrior sign, the rocket fuel sign, and then it was immediately blocked by a brother sign. Speaking of shaking hands.
Yeah, you got a right to celebrate, man.
See, I never actually got a finisher saved up and all that. Yeah, 2K15 mode is really kind of odd. You really are just like, try to get these very specific inputs and you will automatically win. Don't worry too much about winning the game through normal gameplay methods. And the Warrior explodes. The Warrior exploding! The Ultimate Warrior and Rick Rude had been feuding since the 1989 Royal Rumble. They competed against each other in a pose down. Oh yeah, the Ultimate Pose Down, I remember that. Show off their muscles. The crowd believed the Ultimate Warrior was the winner, but Rude attacked the Warrior with a steel bar. This led to a championship match at WrestleMania 5, where Rude pinned Warrior to win the title with the help of manager Bobby Heenan, who held down Warrior's foot from outside the ring as he was being pinned. At SummerSlam 89, Warrior defeated Rude to regain the title and became a two-time Intercontinental Champion. After beating Hulk Hogan for the WWF Championship at WrestleMania 6, Rick Rude would ignite this rivalry again with the Ultimate Warrior when Rick Rude would become the number one contender for the WWF title. Really? These two would battle a steel cage for the WWF title at SummerSlam. Up next, Ultimate Warrior versus Rick Rude. The thing about, one of the things that has been said about Rick Rude many years later, he was good on the mic, he was a great wrestler, and one of the big compliments that's been paid to him. And, you know, I know it's insulting the dead to say it, but Warrior had a reputation for not being, he had a great presentation, didn't really put on good in-ring matches, but Rick Rude had matches with Warrior, which were actually pretty compelling. Now, both these guys have passed on, but that has become, like, one of the things people say about Rick Rude to really talk about what a great worker he was, is that he had great matches with the Ultimate. Warrior's thing was the promos, getting kids excited. I mean, God, how many kids were going around with Warrior face paint? It was incredible. Can't take that away from him. And you can take the Intercontinental title away from him, but only with the help of Bobby the Brain Heenan. And now it's time to see if Rick Rude can take the world title away from the Ultimate Warrior. Spoiler alert, he can't. We get to hear Rick Rude's awesome theme music, too. This will be pretty sweet.
Well, Rick Rude looks like you can't wait to get this match started. One of the most dangerous matches in WWE.
Oh, and they got the old school blue square steel cage. I love this shit. Oh man, I'm really flashing back to great times gone by now. Oh, here we go. How do we get a Rick Rude promo but no Ultimate Warrior promos in this?
What I'd like to have right now,
yes,
is for all you fat,
yeah, I'm listening,
out of shape,
you're talking to me, I know,
canceled sissants. Keep the noise down while I take my robe off and give you a good look at the next World Wrestling Champion.
Oh, come on. He can say Federation. He often did a much more specific one where he basically told the fat-ass men in the crowd to shut up so he could give their ladies the biggest thrill they'd ever get by looking at his body. And they're not seeing his tights yet, but I'm hoping his tights... Traditionally, Rick Rude wore tights with airbrushed pictures, unflattering pictures of his opponents, usually with their face over his butt or genitals.
And the energy just picked up in this place.
His opponent.
I believe he does have a picture of Warrior on his ass.
Forget about the door.
What?
Warrior climbing in the cage. Mind game. Psych it out, Rude.
But he didn't go in through the cage. He didn't forget the door. And Rude's like, I can climb cage too.
I don't get this. Ultimate Warrior may be unnecessarily tiring himself out here.
Yeah, look at Rick Rude just taunting.
What happens if Rude leaves the cage before Warrior comes in? Does he win the title? This was a pretty sweet way for a match to start, I gotta admit.
This is scary. Look how high up they are.
Yeah, I'm thinking I gotta stop LPing this thing and start checking some of this shit out on the network.
Warrior hammering away. Rude's in trouble.
Although, actually, what I really want to do is watch Macho Man's feud from right around the same period where Jake the Snake Roberts is coming after him for no real reason. Rick Rude also had the best feud ever with Jake Roberts, where he pulled some random woman out of the crowd to talk about how sexy he was, and it turns out, in a crazy coincidence, it was Jake Roberts' wife. Special moves, we know mine. Sit out, Paul Driver, nice. He's got a couple of DDTs, but obviously... The Rude Awakening has to be his finisher. Look at that guy. Look at that guy. He's involved in one of my favorite little pieces of body language in the history of wrestling, where during an Iron Man match with Dustin Rhodes, also famous for Rick Rude yelling that, you know, probably not meant to be on mic, but he yells at Dustin Rhodes, and he says, bitch! And Dustin Rhodes says, what you gonna do about it? And Rick Rude responds by yelling, bitch! But it also features Rick Rude taking a shot to the... Like, he's getting beaten in the ribs repeatedly. He hits Dustin with some move that devastates Dustin to the point where Rick Rude gets up. And he does his traditional taunt, which is to put his, you know, hands behind his head, stick his elbows out, and, like, gyrate sexily, moving his ribs around in, like, a sexy dance, which is, like, heel taunt. But he starts doing that, then stops to grimace with pain and double over and grab his ribs. Because he's so devastated by the match, he can't even do his sexy dance properly. Rick Rude's fucking awesome. This is long before people started liking him because he was in ECW. I'm like, you know, way before that. He was so devastated that he pained him to do the sexy dance, yet he had to endure and perform the sexy dance for all those ladies in the crowd who had fat, unattractive boyfriends. Anyway. I want to lightly damage Rude. Okay.
You win either by pinfall or escaping the cage, either through the door or
do it in
the
traditional Warrior way.
Simple, but I assure you, there's nothing simple about competing in a match of this kind.
Damn it! Nobody should be allowed to hip toss the Ultimate Warrior.
Can leave a lifetime.
He is supposed to hit everybody with all of his clotheslines.
This is
totally unrealistic. That's a little bit more realistic. That's how it actually works.
Well, the Ultimate Warrior has been dominant since defeating Hulk Hogan for the WWE Championship at WrestleMania 6.
And even before
this battle, that's grappled him, yeah. Hey, come on.
And look at Rude now. Rude is going for the Rude Awakening.
It's a little early, don't you think?
If he hits this, it could be over.
But Warrior, powering out here.
Oh, big close line by the Ultimate Warrior. And I think he's coming to splash. Yes. Oh, and Rude.
Oh.
Devastating. Great move by Rude. Very, very smart move by Rick Rude. What's he going to do now, though? Staggering over to the... Wait, are you
what
kidding
is
me?
I don't even... I can't tell what his tights say. Warrior's tights stay out of control. Rude's tights say something else.
Wait a minute.
Oh, is he going for a top rope move?
Rude up the top of the cage. Oh, but he's caught by the Warrior right in the stomach.
Man, Rude taking a pretty serious risk there. That was just a dumb move by Rude. He should have climbed out of the freaking ring.
At last year's SummerSlam, these two superstars squared off with the Intercontinental Championship on the line. Fast forward 12
Rude.
Months.
Ooh. And the Ultimate Warrior and Rick Rude. I don't care how many steroids you do, that's still going to hurt.
Prize in all of sports entertainment.
And speaking of the Intercontinental Championship, as we mentioned earlier, the Texas Tornado defeated Bobby Heenan's man, Mr. Perfect, tonight to claim the title. You can bet Heenan will do everything in his power here to ensure his family doesn't walk away with another loss.
It's because he didn't care about winning the world title tonight before Mr. Perfect's defeat.
Oh, man, what a battle this is. And now, whoa.
Oh, the door is open. Why is the door open? I guess because Warrior wasn't going to be able to climb the cage.
For the door now.
I don't remember how this match ends, other than the fact that Warrior wins.
Huge smile on the face of Bobby Heenan.
Yeah, Heenan
brain. Now, there's not a whole lot where you get to see. Bobby the Brain Heenan was the best heel manager ever. I mean, he doesn't get much of a chance to really display that in these games, because you have to hear some of his mic work. But he was pretty freaking sweet. I hope we get to press slam him, though. Using Heenan to build up a superstar meter to get a finisher. Okay, so I actually do have to climb out of the cage.
He didn't need a GPS to find the mark.
That's more like a Warrior match.
Oh, look at the emotion.
Okay, don't want to accidentally do his other, okay. Gorilla press is with triangle, and military press is different, so.
Would you look at the size of Ultimate Warrior's neck, Cole? The champ may very well be.
Why are the fans booing? Do they know he's going to counter?
I haven't seen too many people.
And now, Ultimate Warrior could have this match in the bag.
There you go. So much for saying that they opened the door because a Warrior couldn't climb up. Oh, he's doing a sexy dance, too. Oh, nice. Thank you, Ultimate Warrior, for making our out-of-control ass swivel sexily. Simply Ravishing Warrior.
Rick Rude gave Warrior all the fight he could handle, but in the end, it just wasn't enough.
They should form a tag team called the Ultimate Ravishing. That makes sense, right? Remember telling Bobo once that, gruff partner Bobo, that, I used Ultimate Warrior and Mr. Perfect in, as a team in WrestleFest and called them the Perfect Warriors. And Bobo said, wow, you should totally get a job writing for WWE. Yeah, which one I slapped. Well, I didn't like slap the face, but. I was like, yeah, I call them Perfect Warriors. Wow, that's really creative. Badass belief. That's very creative. Sarcastically. So, yeah, we got to be like halfway done with the story mode by now. I'm enjoying this a lot more than Mark Henry's story, even if the match quality is similar.
At WrestleMania 6, the Ultimate Warrior claimed his rightful place in history.
Then he fought Rick Rude, I guess.
For the WWE Championship. But the glory of one often serves to fuel the fire of envy in others.
Well, yeah, somebody was going to challenge him. Uh-oh. Oh, here we go. Oh, man, I thought we were going to fight Slaughter.
Between Sergeant Slaughter and the Ultimate Warrior. I got a commitment from Sergeant Slaughter saying that if he wins the title, I'm the number one contender.
Shove it down his throat, baby!
Warrior's in a whole lot of trouble!
Oh, man, we're not going to get to actually have the match. They're just going to...
It's pumping through that
So we don't actually get to have this match. I mean, they've done matches before where you lose. He's running into that blurred out logo. Right between the eyes, which are on top of his head.
And cheated out of the championship. The Ultimate Warrior sought to dethrone Randy Savage at WrestleMania 7, pitting career against career.
One of my favorite matches of all time.
King have found the madness. I am the one that will end your career.
Temporarily.
This is a different ball game, Brain. The magnitude of this career-ending matchup for one of these individuals.
Now he's the Macho King. Why is he wearing the cowboy hat? I hope they show the post-match stuff for this, because it's one of my favorite matches of all time. It's one of the like most female fan-friendly matches of all time too.
History. About-
would like to see a little bit more build up to it, but you know, whatever. Yeah, so before I go, let's just point out real quick that during the first Gulf War, the build to the first Gulf War, Sergeant Slaughter betrayed America and accepted a field commission from Saddam Hussein. No, this really happened. In storyline terms, I don't think the real Saddam Hussein was involved. But he did, in fact, claim not to have just joined Iraq, but he claimed to have been personally invited to join the Iraqi army by Saddam Hussein. He had two running buddies. One of them was Iron Sheik. I forget who the other one was, but they were Colonel Mustafa and General Adnan. I think Sheik was General Adnan. I don't know who Colonel Mustafa was. But, the point was, yeah, he fucking joined Iraq and betrayed America, and it was all to build up to a WrestleMania where Hulk Hogan, representing the USA, would win the title from the evil Iraqi traitor Sergeant Slaughter. But in order to do that, they had to get the belt off Warrior, so you have the Macho King hit him with the scepter. Ooh, yeah. So the aftermath of that is basically the Ultimate Warrior is like, I'm going to fucking kill you, Macho Man, you son of a bitch. And they have a career versus career match, which we will see next time. In WWE 2K Shortcase, Way of the Warrior. So, I mean, I'm not doing a lot of crazy in character stuff as Warrior, but I hope the fact that I'm really enjoying this a lot more than I enjoyed, say, Mark Henry. I'm curious. Let me know. I'm curious. You're not going to hurt my feelings either way, but I'm really curious. Amongst people who watched the Mark Henry DLC and the Ultimate Warrior DLC, which one is making a more enjoyable Let's Play? I'm legitimately curious if me being like pissed off and mocking the whole thing openly, or me just being like, oh my god, it's time for the Warrior versus the Macho King. Like, I'm just marking out for shit I watched when I was a kid. I'm not sure which one's actually more enjoyable to watch. I know which one's more enjoyable to record. But I'm curious, so let me know. But when we come back, folks, the freaking Macho King. I mean, how fucking awesome is the Macho King? He dumps... you know, after he loses the ultimate challenge, he loses, the mega powers explode, he loses his title to Hogan, he dumps Elizabeth and takes up with Sensational Sherry, he wins the King of the Ring tournament, becomes the Macho King, takes up with the Sensational Queen Sherry. He's like the epitome of evil, despite the fact that almost nothing about his persona changes. He cuts the exact same promos. I guess that's not true. He doesn't. He stops referring to the fans and saying dig it, and that he loves the fans. And basically, but he's the same insane freak. It's just that now he's fighting against good guys. He and the Warrior are getting ready to have, as I mentioned, one of my favorite matches ever, mostly because of the post game. And the irony being that my other favorite match ever from this era is another Macho Man Ultimate Warrior match, because I guess I just gave it away, folks. This is a retirement match. The loser retires. It didn't stick. Both guys, they actually wrestle each other later. Possibly in the showcase. I don't think they're going to pull out that match. I love the Macho Man versus Ultimate Warrior match from, I think it was SummerSlam 92. Love that match to death because of the storyline build. Mr. Perfect and Ric Flair were sort of lurking in the background. I'm not going to talk about it in case it comes up in the showcase mode, but Macho Man was another one of those guys. Warrior, huge ability to get the crowd excited. Not a lot of ability to deliver in the ring. You know, the guy, he shouldn't speak ill of the dead. I know I couldn't get in the ring and deliver a bust-ass match, but it's just historical fact. He wasn't putting on your, quote, five-star matches most of the time. Although you got to give him at least a star to any match he's in just because of the crowd involvement. But against Rick Rude and against Randy Savage, man, those matches delivered. That was good shit. And what's the word I'm looking for? There's a specific word I'm trying to think of. The bright neon colors and stuff of the WWE, the crazy bright, insane ring garb and screaming and bashings of the chest and rock and theme music. It was all part of an atmosphere that just the WWE doesn't have these days. And that's why I'm looking forward next time to taking out the Macho King, Randy Savage, as the Ultimate Warrior. Again, if you don't understand why I'm into the Warrior, retroactively, because I remember I made a lot of fun of the Warrior at the time, and I was totally on Randy Savage's side against the Warrior, but still retroactively a lot of fun, very fun performer. Go get on the YouTubes, check out some of his promos, and you'll see he was just cutting some crazy ass, and he was saying some crazy ass insane shit to get people pumped, and when you're a pro wrestler, that's a big part of your job. But I don't think Warrior's doing the job next time. We'll see. I'm a Serious GG. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.